Hey, my name is Paul of Evil from Team Origin, and this is my basic champion guide to Orianna. So, Orianna and solo queue has, in my opinion, not really like a hard counter. So you have kind of tough matchups against Zed, Ahri, LeBlanc, but all these matchups are pretty fine for Orianna. So if you played a few games on her, you can literally play a solid and strong mid lane against every mid laner as Orianna. So you can always play and pick her. You can always pick her into certain matchups. So I think in general, she's just a strong mid laner overall, but you should always think about, she's not like a mid laner who is going to 5-0 or 10-0 snowball the enemy mid laner to death and he just completely wrecks the enemy opponent. It's more like you're going to win in team fights. You're going to win with making a 3 or 4 man shockwave happen. So if your team is smart, you sometimes just try to kite back, let them move into your ball range and ult them, instead of just trying to engage on them and go ham. And you just need to look out for positioning your ball correctly. So it should never be like, oh, I'm without my ball, next to me is an Olaf. The early laning phase of Orianna is pretty fine-ish. It's not perfect anymore after the nerfs of lower AD, but you just take Q level 1 and you pretty much just try to keep queuing him. You don't really go for the auto-attack traits, in my opinion. You sometimes can, but just try to give him the Qs while last hitting so you don't lose too many minions. And at level 2, you can decide if you go for the QW combo. So you QW him, give him the auto-attack, which instantly pops the Thunder Lord, and you make really good use of your passive, of your mastery. Or you're going for the more tricky version. You Q him, you eat through him, and auto-attack him afterwards. So you pop the pass at the mastery as well, but you still have a shield if he wants to fight more, and you can go for one more, two more attacks. Other than that, controlling the wave is mostly like, you can zone him with the ball, but it always depends on the matchup. Sometimes you just need to farm with your ball, sometimes you just need to freeze. You just need to like look out for how's the game going. Can you push him into the turret? Can you poke him under the turret? Or is your team so far behind that they will 100% gank you? Because then you need to like stay defensive and don't overextend too hard. Other than that, just try to get as much farm as possible, because you need to reach the four screens. Kind of like the earlier you reach your four screens claim, the more gold you get from the item anyway. So it's good to get the item ASAP. In teamfight, you can go for kiting back and trying to get as many people as possible in your shockwave, or you're trying to shield your AD carry, try to slow the front line so he can kite better, and afterwards you try to go for the shockwave. But it always depends from each game. Like if you think you can burst the front line fast enough, just shockwave them. Like you don't need to make a 5-man shockwave happen or always go for the backline shockwave. If you see the front line and your AD carry is kind of strong, you will manage to kill them really fast anyway. So my tips for Orianna are, first one is you have the ball on yourself. So let's say you just shield yourself and you're playing against Ahri, who has one more ult charge, and with ultimate you're going to kill her. So what you do, you shield yourself, you press ultimate on yourself, and you just flash onto her, which means it's nearly impossible for her actually to flash or to dodge it, but it's really easy to hit. And the only thing you should keep in mind is the ranges are too huge, so you actually need to be kind of nearly onto her. So just to make your life easier as an Orianna, you should just try to, if you have a Malphite or Alistar in your team, and let's say, I think the best is if you actually do Q with him and you have communication going, because then you can just shield him and he will just unstoppable force Malphite ult into them, and if 3 or 4 people at the siege kind of knock up, they can't cleanse it, so your shockwave is really easy to hit. So red runes, marks. I go for hybrid penetration because as Orianna you're doing spells and auto attacks, so which means that it's just the most efficient rune. It's better than going just flat magic penetration or obviously AD penetration. So I think hybrid is nearly on most of the champs really, really good, and I like to go it on Orianna. In yellow, I go in every matchup HP per level, so it's not like nothing is changing there. And in the blue ones, you can pretty much decide. I go in one rune page, I go 10% CDR per level, and the rest I go AP per level. So with the 10% CDR, you can later on, with the right items, you can reach 45% perfectly. So 10% CDR per level. The rest you can go AP per level or magic resistance per level, or even magic resistance flat. It kind of depends on the matchup. And obviously crins is as always in nearly every with every mid lane AP kind of you just go flat AP 3 times. In most of the matchups, I take Sun a lot because it's just so much damage. You get a 5% CDR from the masteries before. It's just a really good build path. I just like the Sun a lot mastery. But in some cases, you can take the Deathfire Touch because you can pop it. If you can pop the Deathfire Touch against melee matchups or low range mid laners, if you can pop it between 4-5 times, it's already more worth it than going for the Sun a lot. So against the LeBlanc as an example, you trade once, so that the Sun a lot makes more sense because in the meantime, she doesn't have a W, she won't trade with you, and you can't really pop the Sapphire Touch too good. But against the Lissandra, who is consistently trying to queue you, you trying to queue her, you can pop it a few times and the Deathfire Touch makes more sense at this point because it doesn't have a CD. So on Arena, I would say in 99% of the matchups, I skill max Q spell and second max W. Nearly never I go a second max shield because you just get so much damage by a W that it's just not worth. And you can't always get the damage from the E spell. Like, you need to be a really good Arena player and you need to have a lot of games to actually make the E spell deal damage to the opponent. So I would suggest to take E spell as the third spell on level 3 and afterwards max Q, afterwards W. And in the lane, you obviously have the option to take level 1 Q spell, you have the option to take level 1 shield, because the first one, obviously, taking Q spell, you can try to play a little bit more aggressive, try to go for the trades. With the shield, you mostly just try to farm. It's good against Cassidy, for example. He tries to Q you, you shield it. And on level 2, you have the option again to take the Q E spell combo, so you Q through him, then you make the obviously your shield and deal damage with it, plus you shield yourself, which is a little bit tricky sometimes, but if you manage to do that, it makes more sense than going for the QW combo. So your first item on Arena should be either Frost Queen's Claim or a Fiend's. I mostly go Frost Queen because of my runes as well. So if you go Frost Queen, you get 10% CDR, you get 50 AP if I recall correctly, and this unique passive, it slows enemies down, you always see where they are, you're in a safe spot if you use them, and it's just a really really strong item, which is like nearly always the better choice than going Moira. So the other option is going a Fiend, which gives you more fighting power, but as I said, I would suggest going Frost Queen. After Frost Queen, you should try to go get CDR boots, so you have already 20% CDR. With your runes, having 30% CDR and blue buff 40%, combined with your masteries, you have already 45% masteries, CDR, and it's like the perfect build. Then you go World of the Ages, which is just like a really, really good scaling item right now, which has, it's really, really cost efficient and gives you everything you need. It gives you a little bit of mana, HP, and damage, so I really suggest that item. Afterwards, you just go kind of like pure fighting power and damage with Rubber Dance and Void Staff. You need to actually look out for if you should buy Void Staff before Rubber Dance, if they have already a lot of mage resistance. If not, just always go for the runes. And as last item, you have the choice between Zhonya's, Lunes, or Rylai's. And you should just look out. Can you, let's say, block a Lux laser? You should go for Zhonya's. If you need to kite a little bit better, I think I would either go for Lunes or Rylai's. But it's kind of your own choice, like which item you prefer the most. Thanks for watching this basic champion guide. Make sure to check out the rest of the guides over at lolclass.com.